All right, y'all, we got a great show tonight. It's Player Talk Radio. Let's get into the J. Cole mix, man. We got a lot of stuff to talk about before tonight's live stream. Let's get it. It's Player Talk Radio. Let's go.
You're now listening to Player Talk Radio. Woo! With the coolest DJ in the manosphere.
Let's go.
DJ Kuda. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Let's go. I see the rain pouring down before my very eyes. Should come as no surprise. I see the rain pouring down before my very eyes. Should come as no surprise. I'm searching and praying and hoping for something. I know I'm gonna see it. I know that it's coming, Lord. Huh. Lord.
Thank you,
but what do you do when there's no place to turn? I have no one. I'm lonely. My prisoners have burned down, Lord. Lord. Bells getting loud, ain't nowhere to hide, got nowhere to go. Put away my pride, tired of feeling low. Even when I'm high, ain't no way to live. Do I wanna die? I don't know. I don't know. Bells getting loud, ain't nowhere to hide, got nowhere to go. Put away my pride, tired of feeling low. Even when I'm high, ain't no way to live. Do I wanna die? I don't know. I don't know. Bells getting louder, louder.
Damn, Kuda. Why you doing like that, baby? Now you know you gotta break the game down a little bit more because they might be slow.
It's Player Talk Radio. We in the building. Let's get it. Let's go. Shout outs to J. Cole. We're gonna get into tonight's show. Let's go.
My head high, I got my wings to carry me. I don't know freedom. I want my dreams to rescue me. I keep my faith strong. I ask the Lord to follow me. I've been unfaithful. I don't know why you call on me. This is my canvas. I'ma paint it how I want it, baby. Oh, I. This is my canvas. I'ma paint it how I want it, nigga. Fuck you, cause there is no right or wrong. Only a song. I like to write alone, be in my zone. Think back to Forest Hills, no perfect home. But the only thing like home I've ever known until they snatched it from my mama and foreclosed her on a loan. I'm so sorry that I left you there to deal with that alone. I was up in New York City chasing panties getting gone. Had no clue what you was going through. How could you be so strong? And how could I be so selfish? I know I could be so selfish. I could tell by how I treat you and my girl. Damn, she's so selfless, but she put up with my ways because she love me like you do. And no, it don't always show. I love her just like I love you. And I need to treat you better. Wish you could live forever so we could spend more time together. I love you, mama. I keep my head high. I got my wings to carry me. I don't know free. Faith strong. I ask the Lord to follow me. I've been unfaithful. I don't know why you call on me. Apparently,
Another day, another rhyme, ho. Another day, another time zone. Today I woke up feeling horny, so it's only right I got two bitches playing on my trombone. Keep up, never sure where the words will take me. Niggas eat them up, will regurgitate me. Shit trunk tight, never slurred, lazy. Give a virgin the urge to rape me, nigga, please. Best friends really make great for enemies. My watch game, niggas can't wait for one of these. I see, nigga, this ain't no Rolex, it's an AP, nigga. I'm hot dog, catch up to me, nigga. Huh, couldn't resist. Aim for the stars and I shouldn't have missed. But I was riding on fumes, so I stopped by the moon. Now I'm sitting on the hood of this bitch, like thanks for the view. Waiting on thanks from a few, cause without me you wouldn't exist. You know that shit gave you the blueprint, don't forget. Cold as your phone on 0%, going off. Now niggas showing off. Niggas where they hop, but they flow ain't soft. I'm taking off like Boeing on a big ass Boeing. Getting hit like a coin toss, too easy. I keep my head high. I got my wings to carry me. I don't know freedom. I want my dreams to rescue me. I keep my faith strong.
A little bit more because they might be slow.
Like, I make a lot of money, you know, and I'm really happy about it. I'm not bragging, I just want to say this. I make a soul fuck, it's ridiculous. Wait a minute. If my father was alive today, I would go home and say, Dad, I'm gonna tell you how much money I make. You know what he say?
You's a lying motherfucker. Joe Louis didn't make that much money. Come in there with your jazz out now. Come in with that bullshit.
Niggas hating on me, I ain't used to that. Know a couple people want to shoot for that. I say no, chill, it ain't no need for that. Them niggas trying to blow and they need me for that. And if it worked for them, well shit, I'm cool with that. Plus how they feel, I ain't got shit to do with that. I just sit back on cool and watch my paper stack.
Player Talk Radio.
And trip off how much bread them crackers take from that. How much was it though?
Half, nigga, you crip, boy, you crazy. Bitch, you crazy. Bitch, bitch, you better suck half my dick.
I pay taxes, so much taxes, shit don't make sense. Where do my dollars go? You see, lately I ain't been convinced. I guess they say my dollars supposed to build roads and schools, but my niggas barely graduate, they ain't got the tools. Maybe cause the tax dollars that I make sure I send get spent hiring some teachers that don't look like them, and the curriculum be tricking them, them dollars I spend got us learning about the heroes with the whitest of skin. One thing about the men that's controlling the pen that write history, they always seem to white out they sin. Maybe we'll never see a black man in the White House again. I write a check to the IRS, my pockets get slim. Damn, do I even have a say about where it's going? Some older nigga told me to start voting. I said democracy is too fucking slow. If I'm giving y'all this hard-earned bread, I wanna know. Better yet, let me decide, bitch, it's 2018. Let me pick the things I'm funding from an app on my screen. Better that than letting whack congressmen I've never seen dictate where my money goes. Straight into the palms of some money-hungry company that make guns that circulate the country and then wind up in my hood making bloody clothes. Straight bullet hit a young boy with a snotty nose. From the concrete, he was probably rose. Now his body and nobody knows what to tell his mother. He did good at the white man's schools, unlike his brother who was lost in the streets all day, not using rubber. So right now he got two on the way, still sleep on covers in his mama house. She can't take this shit no more, she want him out. On the morning of the funeral, just as she's walking out, wiping tears away, grabbing her keys and sunglasses, she remembered that she gotta file her taxes.
Cuda, why you do him like that, baby?
Niggas be thinking I'm deep, intelligent, fooled by my college degree. My IQ is average, there's a young lady out there, she way smarter than me. I scroll through her timeline in these wild times and I started to read. She mad at these crackers, she mad at these capitalists, mad at these murder police. She mad at my niggas, she mad at our ignorance, she wear her heart on her sleeve. She mad at the celebrities, low key I be thinking she talking about me. Now I ain't no dummy to think I'm above criticism, so when I see something that's valid I listen, but shit, it's something about the queen's tone that's bothering me. She strike me as somebody blessed enough to grow up in conscious environment with parents that know about the struggle for liberation, and in turn they provide her with a perspective and awareness of the system and a fairness that afflicts them, and the clearest understanding of what we gotta do to get free. And the frustration that feels the worst seems to come from the fact that most people don't see. Just cause you woke and I'm not, that shit ain't no reason to talk like you better than me. How you gon' leave when you attacking the very same niggas that really do need the shit that you saying? Instead of conveying you holier, come help us get her to speed. Shit, it's a reason it took like 200 years for our ancestors just to get free. These shackles be locking the mental way more than the physical. I look at freedom like trees, can't grow up for us like overnight. Hit the ghetto and slowly start planting your seeds. Fuck is the point of you preaching your message to those that already believe what you believe? I'm also fucking retweet, most people are sheep. You got all the answers, but how you gon' reach? If I can make one more suggestion respectfully, I would say it's more effective to treat people like children, understanding the time and love and patience that's needed to grow. This change is inevitable, but ain't none of us seen this before. Therefore, we just gotta learn everything as we go. I struggle with thoughts on the daily, feel like a slave to somehow to save. There's no coins to buy his way up out of slavery. Think it just maybe in my pursuit to make life so much better for me and my babies. I done betrayed the very same people that look at me like I'm some kind of a hero because of the zeros that's next to the commas. But look here, I promise I'm not who you think. Ran into this nigga outside of the store yesterday. He said something that had me like, wait. He was like, cold. Appreciate what you been doing, my nigga. That's real. But damn, why I feel faker than snow on the bluff? Well, maybe because deep down I know I ain't doing enough.
Thank you.
You're now listening to Player Talk Radio. Woo! With the coolest DJ in the manosphere. You're now listening to Player Talk Radio. Woo! With the coolest DJ in the manosphere.
Let's go.
DJ Kuda. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
What's going on, y'all? It's Player Talk Radio. It's DJ Kuda right back at the helm of today's show. Got a great show for you guys tonight. On tonight's show, man, we're going to be talking about some real shit. Before we get into tonight's live stream, got a great show for you guys tonight. If you got any questions, you can email me at playertalk8@gmail.com. That's playertalk8@gmail.com. Got a great podcast for you guys coming tomorrow. Will probably be some of my thoughts from tonight's live stream. Depends on where it goes, you know, depending on what we're talking about. Shout outs to J. Cole. That was the new cut called Snow on the Bluff, man. You know what I'm saying? And J. Cole been saying the same thing for the longest time. Actually, I want to play something for y'all from the Breakfast Club. It's so funny how fake a lot of people are, how a lot of the media is definitely being fake and pushing, a lot of agendas on us at the same time, where a lot of people don't even know where to go, you know, like the whole Black Lives Matter thing, man. Have you guys checked out the cover of Rolling Stone magazine? How, once again, that was like a slap in the face to black men. The thing is like, how many times do you have to be slapped, punched, and kicked down and undermined by society before people realize that you know what the hell is going on? That you're not dumb. You know, as a black man, you gotta realize, man, you're more alone than ever, man. And, It's built to make you believe that, you know, you have your woman in your corner, but when you really look back on it and see how everything is playing out, you will see that you're undermined by them also. And if there's any good women out there, any and every brother that could use your help, would like you to stand up, would like you to, you know, take a stand, challenge the system. But most importantly, before you even do that, they would like you to listen to them, understand them, because this whole standing up and getting on the front lines is nothing but destroying the community a lot further. And best believe there's younger boys out here that's sitting up here and they're watching all of this, and their time is coming, man. You know, young black boys, man, always remember, man, you're gonna have your day in the sun. And it's going to be a glorious day. And you know, you're going to win. You know what I'm saying? You know, like I said, when all said and done, will there be more said than actually done? One thing that I saw that I'm going to bring up on tonight's live stream is that there's an artist that goes by the name of Kirby. She did a TikTok video. And basically kind of mocking the mammyism of... I guess an advertisement. I didn't know Quaker actually owned Aunt Jemima. So that was one thing. I didn't know they owned the syrup company. But it's funny how the quote unquote stereotypes, you notice she did some type of video, and basically black women now all of a sudden are offended by the stereotypes of Aunt Jemima, and they pulled, I think, Uncle Ben's. They better not mess with the Zatarans. Zatarans. They better not mess with that. But anyway, they pulled Aunt Jemima off the shelf, and they're pulling Uncle Ben off the shelf. So you mean to tell me that black women are offended by Aunt Jemima and Uncle Ben and all of these caricatures or stereotypes that are staples at one point of successful black people on labeling? Because they even, I think even back in the day, I think I was around for that, like in the 90s or something, where they petitioned to kind of change Aunt Jemima's her look. You know, she looked like a beautiful, successful black woman on the cover of the syrup now. Like, it's not like a you know, like a minstrel kind of thing. And it's funny how black women are offended by those caricatures of people that in history they haven't even studied, yet they're not offended by like the Meg Thee Stallions and the women that's perpetuating sex and colorism and all these things. Not Meg, I mean, I'm just making a, you know, a reference, you know, other people like Cardi B and other people that, you know, promote other things that's way worse than, you know, these companies, you know. And that's another thing too that you don't understand going into the future. The reason why that kind of destroys black symbolism is because, you know, now there's just not gonna be no black people on labels. People fought for, at least, I wouldn't say Aunt Jemima, but they still fought reasonably to have black people on labels of things. And you see how Quaker is so quick to pull Aunt Jemima and Uncle Ben's off their packaging, but they're not quick to pull the Quaker Oats man off their shit. You see how that works? You see, sisters, when you don't consult with your brothers, much less care about what they think, they feel it. When you take the time to say that you're on the front lines, and all we see is you out on the front lines twerking and, you know, doing all kinds of stuff, you know, thinking that you're being an activist when it's really not. It's a photo op. It's an opportunity for you to take a photo. You're not really out there marching. Where are you calling out the women that's on the front lines twerking? Where are you actually saying, you know what, Black Lives Matter, we need to be more about our brothers. We need to have programs that support our brothers, and after school programs, and we need to save our little boys so they don't end up like a George Floyd, so they don't end up like a Ahmaud Arbery or Trayvon Martin or Eric Garner. You know what I'm saying? Or Philando Castile. We need to focus more on what's the problem. But they don't want to focus on the problem because this sector of the manosphere has already dealt with those things. And we've already talked about those things extensively. And we've had, and we took up conversations that they don't even want to talk about. So we know where the problem lies. But I mean, it's going to only get worse, y'all. And, you know, shout outs to J. Cole, man. That shit, man, fire. Bars, man. And a lot of people, he didn't tell her to change her tone or watch her tone. He was saying some real shit. J. Cole was like, man, who am I? I'm just a celebrity, man. You don't call me out for no shit. And then, and you know what's funny? I don't like Chance the Rapper anymore. I'm sorry. I did like him, that acid shit, that Let's Get Lost. I did like that shit, but I don't like him anymore. And that was the first time I actually heard of No Name Gypsy. Because the name wasn't just No Name, okay? You talking to somebody that know their music. I remember her as No Name Gypsy. You know? I remember when she was fat. Nigga, I remember when SZA was fat. Hate to bring my boo in it. But anyway, what I'm saying is that, you know what I'm saying? Like, these are women with problems, believing that they're doing something. You're not leading. You're not leading black men. Go out there and put black men in front. Have your brothers in front, but they don't. They always put their brothers behind them Women always put the brothers behind them. That's what the matriarchy is for. That's where that's what it symbolizes. Here you have J. Cole telling you the absolute truth. He has homes he's built for single mothers and all these other things. And they're trying to paint this man into, they're trying to paint what this man said into misogyny. Y'all don't even listen to music no more. Y'all don't listen to music no more. Y'all don't hear what that man just said. And y'all never heard what brothers said because you don't listen to what they're saying. You're too worried about yourself. You go look at that Rolling Stone cover and you see that woman stepping up and you see her holding that little boy's hand. That's a symbolization from slavery, something that you guys don't look up yet. You want to blame every single problem that you have on that. You want to blame that the reason why you cannot cooperate in the man in the household with a man in the household on slavery. You want to blame every single thing on slavery, yet you haven't do your due diligence. Or maybe you know and you just don't want to, you just don't want to hand over whatever power that you've gained. You like to revere to yourself as the most unprotected. You take one Malcolm X quote and just run to the moon with it. Not knowing you're the most protected class in America. You could be outside twerking in front of cops, shooting brothers, killing brothers, saying that brothers never did anything for you. Niggas ain't shit for 60 years. I could keep going. But yet, you want them to believe that you're on the front line. On the front line doing what? Which is for your own personal gain. Then when you have a brother that is actually a good man towards women and serving women and call that shit out, I see how you guys turn on him. Interesting. Well, hopefully you guys come to tonight's show. Running a little bit late, but I just thought I should throw this out there for you. We're going to talk more deeply on it on tonight's live stream. Make sure you're there or you're square. Now we're going to play that cut one more time. And I'm going to throw in an interview at the Breakfast Club about what Charlamagne and them was talking about, which they misconstrued what the brother was saying. But it's just interesting to check it out. So listen, man, we out. It's Player Talk Radio. It's DJ Cuda, man. Make sure y'all hit that Cash App. We out. It's Player Talk Radio. Let's go.
Fuck it up, sis. 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 I love it. 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 Yes, baby. Yes.
Yeah. How does it feel knowing no one wants to fuck you?
That is beautiful. Yes,
that's
sir.
The middle finger, bitch.
Yes, oh, sir.
Kiss my black ass.
Yes, sir.
Your love is a mother.
How does it feel?
Fuck it up, sis. 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 Fuck it up, sis.
Damn, Cuda.
Niggas be thinking I'm deep, intelligent, fooled by my college degree. My IQ is average, there's a young lady out there, she way smarter than me. I scroll through her timeline in these wild times and I started to read. She mad at these crackers, she mad at these capitalists, mad at these murder police. She mad at my niggas, she mad at our ignorance, she wear her heart on the sleeve. She mad at the celebrities, low key I be thinking she talking about me. Now I ain't no dummy to think I'm above criticism, so when I see something that's valid I listen, but shit, it's something about the queen's tone that's bothering me. She strike me as somebody blessed enough to grow up in conscious environment with parents that know about the struggle for liberation. And in turn they provide her with a perspective and awareness of the system and a fairness that afflicts them and the clearest understanding of what we gotta do to get free. And the frustration that feels the worst seems to come from the fact that most people don't see. Just cause you woke and I'm not, that shit ain't no reason to talk like you better than me. How you gon' lead when you attacking the very same niggas that really do need the shit that you saying? Instead of conveying you holier, come help us get her to speed. Shit, it's a reason it took like 200 years for our ancestors just to get free. These shackles be locking the mental way more than the physical. I look at freedom like trees, can't grow for us like overnight. Hit the ghetto and slowly start planting your seeds. Fuck is the point of you preaching your message to those that already believe what you believe? Almost a fucking retweet, most people are sheep. You got all the answers, but how you gon' reach? If I can make one more suggestion respectfully, I would say it's more effective to treat people like children, understanding the time and love and patience that's needed to grow. This change is inevitable, but ain't none of us seen this before. Therefore, we just gotta learn everything as we go. I struggle with thoughts on the daily, feel like a slave to somehow to save. And no coins to buy his way about a slavery. Think it just maybe in my pursuit to make life so much better for me and my babies. I done betrayed the very same people that look at me like I'm some kind of a hero because of the zeros that's next to the commas, but look here, I promise I'm not who you think. Ran into this nigga outside of the store yesterday. He said something that had me like, wait. He was like, Cole, appreciate what you been doing, my nigga, that's real. But damn, why I feel faker than snow on the bluff? Well, maybe cause deep down I know I ain't doing enough.
Now, yesterday I told you when I woke up, J. Cole was trending and I didn't know why. And he had put out a new song, Snow on the Bluff, and it caused all kinds of controversy. Now, a lot of people are assuming that he's talking about No Name, who is also an artist and she's an activist. And they didn't like that. They didn't like what he had to say. They didn't like the fact that he discussed her tone. And she actually tweeted out Queen Tone. So that's why people feel like she, and she clearly felt like it was about her as well. She deleted that though. Now, what they're tracing this back to is a Twitter post from May 29th. And she tweeted out, poor black folks all over the country are putting their bodies on the line in protest for our collective safety and your favorite top selling rappers, not even willing to put a tweet up. And we're told discographies be about black plight and they nowhere to be found. So when J. Cole said that she's low-key, he low-key thinks she's talking about him, that might be what that was. Yeah. And then the next day, J. Cole was outside participating in a rally.
Yeah, very interesting. I was trying to figure out why people were so mad at Cole because he sounded like he was dissing himself in that record. They made this sound like he made.
So now what they're trying to do is try to make it seem like Hit Dog Holler.
Ether hit him up towards No Name. All I heard was Cole bowing down to this young lady. Cole said, she's smarter than me. She's really out here doing the work. And when Cole says her tone is bothering me, first of all, I don't know how you read tones through Twitter, but clearly whatever she's saying on Twitter hit a nerve and a Hit Dog will holler. And the message that young queen No Name is putting out is resonating with folks, and it clearly hurt Cole's spirit. Mm. And I don't think No Name needs to watch her tone at all. Keep speaking. Cole can be hurt, and he has the right to express that, and No Name has the right to not care.
Well, J. Cole responded on Twitter. He said, morning, I stand behind every word of the song that dropped last night. Right or wrong, I can't say, but I can say it was honest. Some assume to know who the song is about. That's fine with me. It's not my job to tell anybody what to think or feel about the work. I accept all conversations and criticisms, but let me use this moment to say this. Follow at No Name. I love and honor her as a leader in these times. She has done and is doing the reading and the listening and the learning on the path that she truly believes is the correct one for our people. Meanwhile, an M-word like me just be rapping. I haven't done a lot of reading and I don't feel well equipped as a leader in these times, but I do a lot of thinking and I appreciate her and others like her because they challenge my beliefs. And I feel that in these times, that's important. We may not agree with each other, but we got to be gentle with each other.
Man, see that right there? I think that people are more hurt that Cole told y'all he's just an N-word that be rapping, and he don't be reading like that.
But you think they expect more out of him? You think they expect more out of him?
Yes, I think that. I think that hurt his fans to realize Cole isn't who y'all made him out to be, and that's not Cole's fault either. That's y'all's fault. Just because somebody is a leader in rap, even a thought leader in rap, doesn't mean that they're a leader in social justice. J. Cole is not Tamika Mallory. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, just because you're one of the leaders of the new school when it comes to rap doesn't mean you're a leader when it comes to social justice. And that's fine. If I show up to a protest, that doesn't mean I'm an activist. That just means I'm there in support. It's a difference. So that's
plus, maybe he listens to audiobooks. And now Chance the Rapper responded. He said, they both my peoples, but only one of them put out a whole song talking about how the other needs to reconsider their tone and attitude in order to save the world. It's not constructive and undermines all the work No Name has done. It's not black women's job to spoon feed us. We grown.
Chance has a point. He has a point. Like, it's not anybody's job to spoon feed you, you know. But like I said, just because Cole is a leader of the new school when it comes to rap doesn't mean that he's a leader when it comes to social justice. And he might just be the guy that creates the soundtrack for the movement. And that don't mean he got to lead it.
Right. So, well, that's the controversy. So for everybody who was trying to figure it out like I did at first, that's what it's all about.
I still don't get it, but hey.
Well, I think y'all going to learn about telling black women to watch their tone. I know that much.
Well, no, I get it now. But I'm saying when it first was trending and I was like, let me listen to the song. And I was trying to catch it all. I didn't know all the behind the scenes things until everybody started tweeting and responding to each other. And so now I know.
I think a healthy conversation is great. And he got what he said, what he wanted to feel. And she said what she wanted to say. But, you know, like I said, I hate the cancel culture. I hate when somebody says something that people don't like. We automatically say, cancel him, cancel him, cancel him. I love the open dialogue, but we need to have these conversations.
Y'all need to cancel Simp the Rapper.
When the last time you told your wife to watch her tone, Envy?
I would never. I would never tell any woman to watch their tone.
But you can tell your people exactly. Tell their kids that, though. That's how you talk to your children.
I don't want to get no black eye.
I wish I would tell my wife watch her tone. I wish I would tell all my sister friends around me watch their tone. Watch their tone. Okay. All right.
Black eye immediately. I might be missing it too.
So what I'm trying to ask you guys is where within that song, and I played it twice for the slow and impaired, where within that song did you hear him tell her to watch her tone?
Am I lying?
Like I said, no name don't have to tone her tone down at
not
all.
Not at all.
Keep speaking.
Not at all.
And Cole has the right to be hurt, but Cole has the right to be hurt and express that. But, you know, you just got to take the
question and why I put up this picture. Will your woman ride for you, man?
The consequences that come with telling women to watch their goddamn tone. I try it after day when I'm feeling. If I feel down.
Try what?
A little bit.
Call me when you do it. I want to hear this one.
I don't bungee jump, so you know I don't do stuff like that. So I need something to get a little thrill.
Right, oh, that's gonna be a thrill.
I might tell Amanda Steeles watch her tone today, just because and see what happens.
Yeah, all right.
All right, and Let's move on to Cardi B. She is denying that she's photoshopping her body. I guess people were saying that she photoshopped pictures. They posted some pictures of her in Target.
Well, all right, y'all. There you have it. They can be mad at J. Cole. They can remove Aunt Jemima and Uncle Ben off of a whole bunch of black products and blah, blah, blah. But Cardi B. Hey, shout outs to Cardi B. We out.
Coronavirus! Coronavirus!
It's Player Talk.